Before jumping into color, I planned this painting with a value study. Check out my video on how to paint watercolor value studies to see that process. Now that I feel more confident with my approach, I'm ready to go from a monochromatic study to a full color painting. In this video, I'll walk you through my color choices first. I always plan a limited color palette before I start painting. Then, once I choose the colors, you can relax and watch the painting develop. I put a link to the reference photo and the line drawing in the video description so you can paint this with me. My idea for this color palette was to use complementary colors. Overall, the reference photo is yellows and oranges. I wanted to experiment with using complementary colors in the shadows. So the complement for yellow is purple, and for orange, it's blue. I played around first with using burnt sienna for my orange and yellow ochre for my yellow, but I quickly realized the yellow ochre was too dull for this painting. The yellow color around the door is much more saturated, so I switched to new gamboge. The burnt sienna and new gamboge look great together for the wall colors. Together, they'll work well for the warm golden wood tones on the door, too. For the middle value shadows, I mixed a little quinacridone violet into my new gamboge. It creates a warm, reddish golden color, perfect for the lighter shadows falling on the yellow wall. For the darkest shadows, I wanted to go even more purple. Quinacridone violet is the only purple I have, but it's very warm. It's a purple leaning toward red. To make it darker and cooler, I added French ultramarine. I also know that I can always mix burnt sienna and French ultramarine together to create a nice dark gray, almost black color. Lastly, I need a green for the leaves. With the colors I've already chosen, I can mix new gamboge and French ultramarine together to make a dark olive green. I have chosen four colors for this painting: new gamboge, burnt sienna, quinacridone violet, and French ultramarine. To preserve some highlights on the wall edges and door hardware, I used masking fluid applied with my dip pen. With my limited color palette set, I'm ready to paint. Please enjoy this time lapse of the full painting process. For more detailed instructions, check out the value study video for a narrated tutorial. Also, check out my last video where I shared the color palette and painting process for this fun turquoise door.